I was like, Dad, I can't do this anymore. So he's like, what are you gonna do? I'm like, I'm gonna become a DJ. And he was just like, that's not a real job. Yo, what up, guys? This is Acraze, and this is the story of Due to It. I was watching all the Ultra live streams and like all the Tomorrowland live streams. I'm like, the only way for me to get on these stages is if I like learn how to produce music, because no one's just a regular DJ here. Everyone makes their own music. 2016 is when I actually started. I told my parents, like, it was 2 years after high school, like, what the hell are you doing? Like, you need to go to college or you need to figure something out. Like, you're gonna come work with me. So I worked with my dad for a while, and he works for like this electricity company. In the meantime, I'm like listening to like tutorials, like how to make music in my ears, and like while I'm like digging holes, and I'm like, eventually I gave up. So he's like, what are you gonna do? I'm like, I'm gonna become a DJ. And he was just like, that's not a real job. You need to find things that are gonna make you money. I was like, screw this, I'm running away from home. I need to chase this dream. My friend Dakota, who was actually in Acraze, he was like, yo, you can come live with me for a while. You know, I didn't have a job. So the only thing I did was make music for like 13, 14 hours a day. And then like 2 years after I moved in with him, I ended up making like Jersey club music. It was just like really getting big because Skrillex was starting to play it too. It was like a genre that Skrillex really liked. I ended up remixing one of his songs. He ended up playing it. And so like that was like my big break, and like everyone was trying to figure out what remix this was. So like all the DJs started asking me for it. Fast forward to quarantine, from 2020 to 2021, I was making house records. One of those songs was Due to It. I have like my desk, my bed, and my whiteboard. I mean, that's the only three things that I really look at in my room. In my whiteboard, I usually like every 2 weeks I erase it and I write something new, whether it's like to finish a certain amount of songs or like just random stuff. During that time, I wrote down like what people weren't doing and what people were doing. What people weren't doing, I felt at that time was not enough of like the R&B samples, maybe with like house music or like trap drums. I don't know, I was trying to figure something out. 2 weeks later, that's when I was on Instagram and I saw this girl who got a new car, and she was just like jamming to the original Due to It. I hadn't charged my phone the night before, so it was like on 1%, and somehow in the universe my phone started to like glitch, and it just kept saying bounce with it, bounce with it, bounce with it, and then it died. Wow, this could be like a really cool idea for like what I'm trying to do here. So I look at my whiteboard, I'm like, this could be something. So I go to my little desk, sit down in my chair, open up the laptop, and you know, I chopped the vocal up, I put some terrible drums on it, I made a little intro, and I mean, that was it. Due to It was born in like an hour. You know, fast forward to New Year's, I played the record, and you know, I got like the craziest response, like 500, 600 DMs, and people were like asking me, what's this record? And then all the DJs were asking about it. A week later, I got home and I ended up like actually structuring the song. I think the first person to play like that was big was like Snake, DJ Snake. I remember sending it to him. He was like, yo, this is a hit. It was the weekend of Hard Summer in the US. Everyone on the main stage in one day just played the song. I tweeted about it and I was like, this is so crazy. I've never seen like one song played by every single DJ on the main stage. It was really cool. Seeing 3.3 million videos like on TikTok is completely like, so I would have never thought that would have happened. Megan Thee Stallion did one which was really cool. What also helped go viral on TikTok was the Zed edit at EDC Vegas. He hit me up on Instagram and was like, yo, I'm gonna use your song as my intro. So then I heard that he did the Squid Games edit. He texted me like moments after that and was like, bro, with all caps, with like 30 O's, like, bro. So I was like, what happened? He was just like, you gotta see this video. So then the next day he posted it and like it went so viral on Instagram and then like TikTok, you know, ate it up. Something that I'll never get tired of, you know, like regardless of if it's 10 years down the road, because there's gonna be a new batch of people, right? I'm still gonna be playing it. It's like my first hit, so I enjoy playing something that I've worked so hard on, and it's like my baby, you know, like it's something that I really love, so I'll never get tired of playing it.